How powerful was the Megalodon compared to today's sharks? We put you in a helicopter, flown you out above the deep sea, and dropped you right into the ocean. What's your first concern? Sharks, as it should be. They are the scariest animals in the ocean for a lonely floating human being, and for many other sea creatures. They're solid muscle. They have two speeds, swim and murder. And as powerful as they are, they may not be quite as powerful as their ancient ancestor, the Megalodon. So, how do they stack up to their great-great-great-granddaddy? Do any of today's sharks match up to the Megalodon? Megalodon. For anyone who thinks the power of the Megalodon has been greatly exaggerated, just look to the name. Not Regulorodon, Megalodon. This shark was enormously powerful. Megalodon first appeared in our oceans about 23 million years ago, terrorizing the fish that existed at that time. They had to endure this madness for about 20 million years, as 3.6 million years ago, a collective sigh was heard from the ocean. The Megalodon had gone extinct, but for those 20 million years, he was an apex predator of the ocean. Think about how the T-Rex dominated the land during his time on this planet. This was the Megalodon in the ocean. Many of today's sharks didn't appear until after Megalodon's time, or had such slight overlap with him that it was just a blink of an eye. So, Megalodon ran those oceans like a king. Megalodon ate fish, turtles, and large marine mammals. He had a tremendous appetite, so he'd take on big prey, or many small prey. Like many sharks today, Megalodon used his stealth qualities to wait for his prey to near, and then he would ambush them with his speed. His prey may have been fast, but he banked on his sudden quick burst speed to lend him the ability to get close enough to use that sensational power, especially that of his jaws. When Megalodon bit down on his prey, that prey's grandmother felt the pain. His bite was so strong that we'll need more time to unravel the complexities of it a little later. You can't wrap your mind around this powerful bite, not yet. Bull shark. They tell you to stay out of the ocean to avoid sharks. The problem is, some sharks can exist in freshwater too. The scariest of them all is the bull shark. Not a cute nickname that has no meaning. This thing is strong and aggressive like a bull. A bull shark is one of the strongest sharks, pound for pound. It has incredible sudden burst ability, fast twitch muscles, capabilities to attack and chomp into a prey before the prey even knows its prey. It has one of the top 10 strongest bites of all living animals, and the second strongest among sharks, but it isn't even one of the top 10 largest sharks. Bull sharks are about 7 to 11 feet long, and weigh between 300 and 500 pounds when fully grown. They're the reason you also want to be careful when jumping in a river as well as the ocean. The bite force of a bull shark is 1350 psi. Over 1,000 pounds of force clamping down on you for every square inch of that mouth. Extrapolate that out to the size of a megalodon, and we may have a problem. We told you pound for pound, the bull shark is one of the best, but he is still undersized, especially compared to the megalodon. The bull shark could be the feisty sidekick of the megalodon, using the same methods and same strong bursts of speed and power. But while the bull shark took out the henchmen, Megalodon would be tasked with taking out the bosses. If the bull shark ever turned on the Megalodon, he'd be fish food. More specifically, Megalodon food. The bull shark might leave some marks, a couple scars, but the Megalodon would rip him to pieces. He's too small for the Meg. Hammerhead shark. The hammerhead shark is named after his distinct look, one of the most unique looks in the ocean. The great hammerhead, the largest species of hammerhead, is also one of the top 10 largest sharks in the ocean, coming in at number 7. A great hammerhead is about twice the length of a bull shark, 20 feet long, and they can be twice the weight, sometimes hitting 1,000 pounds. It's the biggest hammer you ever saw. Plus, it has a mouth with sharp teeth. However, looking back to the bull shark, that's the shark with the third most attacks and kills on humans. The hammerhead is not in the top 3, or top 5, or even top 10. There have been no confirmed attacks on divers from a great hammerhead, but that speaks more to their level of aggression than it does their strength. 20 feet long, muscular, if they decided to attack a diver, that diver would be in trouble. But hammerheads, though strong, lack the aggression, and they lack the big bite force. We're not saying go out and get bitten by a hammerhead. They still bite with a force of around 550 psi. It's just not strong among sharks, nor is it anywhere near the megalodon. The megalodon, by all accounts, would have been a more aggressive shark. He not only has the stronger bite and the bigger size, he has the aggression on his side. The hammerhead wouldn't even be the first to attack, affording himself any advantage. Another shark that can't quite stack up to the megalodon. Blue shark. Okay, we're going to turn two dials in opposite directions. We're turning the size dial down a bit, but we're going to dial up that aggression quite a ways. Our test subject is the blue shark. Unlike the hammerhead, he's extremely aggressive, attacking when threatened, when provoked, and even when not provoked. The blue shark is just one of those fish that wants trouble, but the blue shark is more in line with the size of the bull shark, between 9 and 11 feet, and between 200 and 400 pounds. So, he's basically the same length, but maxing out at a lesser weight. He's aggressive like the bull shark, but leaner and a little less muscular. Maybe he doesn't have the build of a bull shark, and maybe he doesn't have the bite, but he's got the aggression and the attitude. If a blue shark was to see a megalodon, he may attack unprovoked. An important thing when it comes to a fight, be the first to swing, or bite in this case. A blue shark may attack first, and though he might get some good shots in, our megalodon would get the last several shots in. Hopefully, for the sake of the blue shark, we hope those last few shots would be the ones to scare him away, because the alternative is that they would end him. Blue sharks are fast, yes, hitting speeds of up to 43 miles per hour. No doubt he could use that to his advantage, swimming circles around a meg and getting in hit after hit, but it would be like watching a featherweight boxer heavyweight. All the big guy needs to do is land a couple punches, and the title is all his. Oceanic white tip. The oceanic white-tip shark is the shark that doesn't get enough credit for how destructive he is. In fact, we may not even know the lengths. Only 12 confirmed attacks on humans and 3 confirmed deaths. But there is plenty of reason to believe that the unconfirmed numbers are far higher. Did you ever hear the story about the boat, the Nova Scotia, that sunk during World War II? Somewhere around 1,000 men were aboard that ship, falling into the water, just trying to survive. Over 800 casualties that day. Yes, some men died for varying reasons, but the survivors will tell you most of the men died when the sharks showed up. And they yanked the crewmen under the water, and they bit, and they ripped, and they chewed, and they swallowed. The descriptions of the sharks don't match great whites or blue sharks, or any other of the top killers, but they match the oceanic white tip. It's a secretive shark that not too much is known about, but clearly it is strong and it is hungry. Oceanic white tips are 10 to 13 feet long, 200 to 400 pounds, and with a bite close to 1,300 pounds per square inch. Close to the bull sharks. Even though his species may have consumed more people than any other shark on the planet, he hasn't consumed any megalodons. He'd put up a fight, but it's going to take a lot more than that. In order for today's sharks to have a chance, we need a bigger shark. Can anyone find us a bigger shark? Tiger shark. How about the fourth largest shark in the world in terms of length and the largest non-filter feeding shark? That would be the tiger shark. Tiger sharks on average are between 15 to 18 feet in length, but we want to take our biggest specimen to match him up against the megalodon. How about the tiger sharks that are over 24 feet long? The ones that can weigh up to 2,000 pounds. That's the one we want. Yes, tiger sharks, the shark with the second most confirmed attacks and kills on humans. That's the competitor we want. The one who is an opportunistic eater, eating everything from fish to turtles to other sharks. Remember that blue shark we talked about? The feisty one? Yeah, tiger sharks eat them. Okay, so do we have a competitor here? Someone in the weight class? Hey, let's not say the same weight class, but hey, the tiger shark is the shark that would put up the best fight of any that we've seen so far. He'd use that burst speed of his, he'd attack, he'd bite, and ultimately, he'd lose. The megalodon might take a little longer with this fight, but in the end, he'd emerge victorious. But the tiger shark is the largest non-filter feeding shark in the ocean today, in terms of length. So, is it not all about length then? What are we missing? Great white shark. We're missing girth. That's what the great white shark would tell you. And boy, does the great white bring the girth. So he isn't quite as long as the tiger shark, but he's close. On average, they're 12 to 16 feet long, but the biggest great whites can be about 21 or 22 feet long. And they typically weigh around 2,000 pounds, but they can hit 2,500 pounds often enough. And this isn't sitting around on the couch weight. Great whites, like all sharks, are constantly moving. It's all muscle. A couple feet shorter, a few thousand pounds heavier, that is a muscular shark. So powerful. The strongest shark in the ocean today, and not just in terms of his body. His jaws, holy cow. Seriously, he'd turn a cow into Swiss cheese if one was dropped in the ocean. The great white has the strongest bite of any shark, 4,000 PSI. That's about 3 times as strong as the bull shark, who is number 2. It's also the 3rd strongest bite of any living animal. If you look at the great white, he's built just like the Megalodon in terms of proportions, but he just isn't as big or strong and a bite. I'm so sorry, Mr. Great White, you may have the crown for strongest bite of all living sharks, but you'll never break the records in the history books. This is why no living shark is a match for the Megalodon. Reason 1, the Great White's bite 4,000 PSI. Do you want to know what animal had a bite force of 8,000 PSI? A T-Rex. Do you want to know what animal has a bite force of 19,000 PSI? An orca. Do you want to know which animal has a bite twice as strong as an orca, 5 times as strong as a T-Rex, and 10 times as strong as a great white? The Megalodon, 40,000 PSI. Strongest bite that ever chomped down on an unfortunate soul in the history of the planet. Oh, and reason 2, it wasn't just a bite, it was the overall size. 50 to 60 feet long, somewhere around 37 tons. Tons! That's 74,000 pounds. The Great White would have put up the best fight, but every fight from every one of today's sharks would have resulted in a losing effort. The only difference would have been, how badly did they lose?